Wave optics is the new chapter that we are going to start today. So in wave optics, we will consider light, propagation of light in the form of waves. Now first we need to see what is meant by wave. Actually, wave is carrying energy from a source. If you have a light source, the light source will propagate waves. And the energy of the light source is carried through waves from the source to the observer or to a particular point. Okay, so we can imagine many waves surrounding a source of light. So a wave is actually carrying a disturbance, or we can say it's energy. Energy is carried from one point to another. We might have noticed that if we have a still water in a bucket, if we put a stone at the center, surrounding the stone, you can see a circular shape, ripples are seen. Why? The stone will give its energy to the molecules. The molecules will share the energy to the nearby molecules and so on. So on the water surface, you can see waves like this. So in the form of ripples, the energy is carried from the point where we have dropped the stone to the edge of the bucket. To that direction, the wave is propagated. Okay, so that's about wave. So wave is a disturbance which carry energy from or we can say it's a pattern of the propagation of energy or the oscillation from one point to other. That's called a wave. Okay, now we need to learn another term called what is meant by phase of a wave. So I will draw two waves to understand the concept of phase. Suppose I have the wave, I have two waves. This is one wave. Okay, I have drawn propagation of one wave, crust, trough, again crust, trough. This is second wave. Two waves I consider. Two waves on a string I can consider like this. So for this wave, this height is called amplitude. Now this particle, so it is representing vibration of the particle. Vibration of particle of the medium. When wave propagates through a medium, the particles of the medium will vibrate to and fro. So this vibration at the highest point of the amplitude, corresponding to this, the angle value is called phase. Here the angle value is pi by 2. It is 0. Here the angle value is pi. Here correspondingly the angle value for the trough, it will be 3 pi by 2. Here it will be 2 pi. Here it will be 5 pi by 2 and so on. Okay, here also I will mark the same points. 0, it is pi by 2, it is pi. Here it is 3 pi by 2 and it is 2 pi. Here it is 5 pi by 2. Okay, so I have considered two waves on two strings. When I consider these two points, I consider first point here and these two points. For both the waves I consider two points, I can say that these points are having a phase of pi by 2. These points are having a phase of pi. These points are having a phase of 3 pi by 2. I can say these points are in same phase, having a phase value pi by 2. These points are having a phase value pi. These points are having a phase value 3 pi by 2. These points are having a phase value 2 pi. These points having a phase value 5 pi by 2. Then we can say they are in phase. Okay. So let us consider a source of light. Let S be a source of light. I'll consider a source of light S. Surrounding the source, I am just going to draw four waves. There are many waves surrounding the source. I just consider four waves. So this is first wave, one wave, crust and trough. Again, crust and trough. Okay. Now, second wave I just draw here. Crust, then trough. Again, the crust and the trough. So two waves each. So one crust and trough, another crust and trough. And second one. Now third also I'm just going to draw, crust, then trough, again crust and one more trough. Here also I'll draw like this, one crust and trough. Okay. Now what I need to do is, I just locate points where particles are vibrating at a phase pi. Okay, I locate the points here. Here the particle is vibrating at phi, pi is a phase. Here I can say pi is a phase. Here I can say pi is a phase. Here pi will be the phase. Okay. I join these points where particles are vibrating at a phase value pi. So what is the shape I am getting? If I draw in 3 dimension, I will get a spherical shape. Another I will see 5π/2. Okay, so for 5π/2, this will be the point for this wave, and here this will be the point, here this will be the point, here this will be the point. Again I draw these points, join these points. What will be the shape you are going to get? You will get another sphere. Okay, so if you draw many such waves surrounding the source of light, when we join these points having same phase, here phase value is 5π/2, here phase values are pi each. Okay, so I can say these particles, when the wave is propagating to the medium, the particles of the media, for these particles the phase will be same. Phase is having a value 5π/2. For these particles the phase is having a value pi. Okay, so I have got two spheres in 3 dimension. When you draw in 2 dimension, you're getting circle. When you draw in 3 dimension, what you are getting? You're getting a sphere. Okay, these spheres are called wave fronts. The spheres are given a specific name called wave fronts. So here, what is the shape of wave front? It is spherical wave front. So we can say for a point source, what is the shape of the wave front? What is wave front? Wave front is a surface where at each and every point particles are vibrating in phase. These are spherical wave fronts. So for a point source, this is a point source. For a point source, what is the shape of wave front? The wave front will be spherical in shape. Now I can draw, I can indicate direction of propagation. If this is source of light, wave front is propagating like this. So to understand the direction, to indicate direction of propagation, we can draw lines like this with arrow mark. These lines are called rays. And rays are perpendicular. Rays are perpendicular to what? Wave fronts. That's an important point. Rays are perpendicular to wave front. Okay, so that's about wave fronts. We have seen spherical wave front. Now we'll draw a line, linear source. Suppose we have a source of light linear in shape. It's a linear source of light. Now a symmetrical wavefront shape we can draw similar to this. Here the wavefront will be having a shape of cylinders. We can say concentric cylinders we can draw. This is one cylinder. Now I can draw another sphere cylinder inside. It's a small wavefront. So the light ray is propagating in this direction. So I can draw these are the rays. These rays are representing direction of propagation. So I have drawn 2 cylinders. These cylinders will be cylindrical wavefront. So here for line source, the linear source, what is the shape of wavefront? It will be cylindrical wavefronts. You can draw cylindrical wavefronts. Cylindrical wavefronts. For point source, what is the shape? Point source, we can draw spherical wavefronts. Spherical. Spherical wavefronts we have drawn. Now we'll see. If the object is at a distance, a far distance away, if it is a point object and it or any source of object, any shape of object, it is very far away. So when the wavefronts reach the observer, the wavefronts will be plane shape, not spherical or cylindrical, it will be plane shape. We can draw light rays from infinity or from far away object. Light rays, we know that light rays are parallel to each other. Now I can draw plane wavefront. These are plane wavefronts. One plane wavefront, I can draw second wavefront like that. These are plane wavefronts. Plane wavefronts. Okay. So if the object is far away, the wavefronts will be plane wavefront. If the object is a point source, it will be spherical wavefront. For linear source, it will be cylindrical wavefront. Okay. So that's about wavefronts. So what is wavefront? Wavefront is a surface where at each and every point particles are vibrating in phase, same phase. You have seen 2 wavefronts here with a phase value pi, here with a phase value 5π/2. Okay, now we use an important principle related to this wavefronts, that is known as Huygens principle. Huygens principle. It's a very important principle. It helps us to locate the position of the wavefront, since the wavefronts are propagating. After a particular time, where will be the wavefront? If you want to understand that, this principle can help us. Okay, now we'll see that. Suppose I have a linear source of light. According to Huygens principle, if I have a point source of light, I just draw 2 rays. I'm drawing 1 wavefront at a particular time. At a particular time, let this be the wavefront. I'll just name the wavefront. I have drawn full wavefront. A portion of the spherical wavefront is drawn here. According to Huygens' principle, each point on the wavefront act as sources of secondary wavelet. So each point on the wavefront can act as sources. They are called fresh sources. These sources can produce what? Secondary wavelets. Okay. Now this is one wavefront at a particular instant. I need to draw the wavefront after a time t. And we know that wavefronts are propagating with the speed of light. What is speed of light? Speed of light is having a value c. After a time t, it will travel a distance c into t. So this is a distance traveled by the wavefront after time t. So with this distance, I will take, I'll draw spheres. Spheres surrounding these points. I'll draw one sphere surrounding this point. Another sphere surrounding this point. What is the radius of the sphere? The radius of the sphere will be z into t. Because at a speed c, the wavefronts advance forward. So I have drawn a few spheres around these points. Because these points act as sources. These spheres are called secondary wavelets. So they propagate secondary wavelets. Okay, so these are secondary wavelets. So I am drawing a few secondary wavelets, spherical in shape. What I need to draw? I need to join the outer envelope like this. In the forward direction, I join the outer envelope. I will mark the envelope A1, B1. This is another spherical wavefront. So this is also a spherical wavefront after a time t. This is the wavefront. AB is a wavefront at a particular instant. And after a time t from that instant, A1, B1 is a new wavefront. So to draw the position and shape of new wavefront, what we can use? We can use Huygens principle. Same thing we can do for a plane wavefront also. So we have the rays and I will draw the plane wavefront. One plane wavefront is drawn. I need to locate the new wavefront after a time t. So what I will do? I will consider each point on the wavefront. This is AB. Each point on the wavefront we need to consider as sources, new sources. And I will draw spheres, spheres with the radius c into t. So and this is one sphere with the radius c into t, another sphere with the radius c into t, another sphere. Each sphere is having a radius c into t. What's the center of the sphere? The point, the sources will be the centers of the sphere. Here also sources, these points are indicating sources. The source of propagating secondary wavelet. So source point will be considered as spheres. What is the radius I have taken here? C into t. Now I will draw the outer envelope. When I draw the outer envelope, I will get another wavefront, another plane wavefront A1, B1. This will be the wavefront after a time t. This was the wavefront at a time, at a particular time AB. A1, B1 is the wavefront after a time t. Okay, so that's about wavefronts and Huygens principle. Now we'll see what happens when plane wavefronts pass through a convex lens and a concave lens. Okay, now we have a few plane wavefronts. These are the rays. And these are the plane wavefronts. I will draw two wavefronts. I will mark AB, CB. These are wavefronts. These wavefronts are going to pass through a convex lens. These are parallel light rays. What will happen? These light rays will meet at a point on the principal axis. This will be focus. At focus, they will meet. Okay. So what happens to shape of the wavefront? When under the refraction through a lens, the shape of the wavefront will be like this, it will be curved like this. It will be spherical wavefront, but it is curved in this direction towards. Okay, this is a wavefront, shape of wave. I can draw A dash, B dash, this is Z dash, D dash, and so on. So these are the shape of wavefront after refraction through what? Convex lens. Similarly, if you have a concave lens, when light rays pass through a concave lens, you can see what happens to the shape of the wavefront. I'm drawing two light rays. These are two parallel light rays. These are the wavefronts. Okay. I mark here X, Y, and this is M, N. Now this, we know that these light rays are already diverging away. So what happens is that wavefront also will take a spherical shape opposite to that. So curvature is in the opposite side direction. These are the wavefronts. I can say X1, Y1, and this is M1. N1. Okay, these are the wavefronts after refraction. So both are spherical curved wavefronts, but the curvature is in the opposite direction for convex lens and a concave lens. Similarly, we can draw the wavefront when a plane wavefront passes through a prism. These are two parallel light rays, and I can draw one plane wavefront. I will say AB. These wavefronts, this light rays will undergo refraction like this. Okay, these are the refract light rays. This will be the wavefronts after refraction, A dash, B dash. So, what happens here? The refracted wavefront and incident wavefront are plane surfaces, but the orientation is changed. If this is orientation of incident wavefront, it will through an angle, through this angle. So these are the variation of the shape of wavefront when it passes through, when it undergo refraction by convex lens, concave lens, as well as prism. Okay, that's about wavefronts and Huygens principle. Remember, Huygens principle is very important to draw the shapes of wavefront at a particular time, after a particular time. If you know the wavefront at a particular time, after a particular time, if you want to draw the wavefront, we can get the help of the Huygens principle. Okay, according to Huygens principle, each point on the wavefront act as sources of secondary wavelets. These spheres we are drawing are called as secondary wavelets. And these are the wavefronts after a particular time. Okay, thank you.